I've been in love with Studio One. It's a tool that I really, really like. And today I have a question for Studio One. And so let's jump into Studio One so that I can show you what is the question. And by the way, the question is how to create effects and buzz channels in Studio One. So let's go to Studio One here. And if you know FL Studio or, for instance, Ableton, and if you worked with several DAWs, then this DAW will not be too frightening, I guess. That's the best word. Sometimes when we switch DAWs, it can be a little bit cumbersome to get into the DAW. But I think Studio One is very, very intuitive. The way to work with Studio One is amazing, I think. And it's... I can see some of the things that I like in Studio One. I could see them in FL Studio, but yeah, I think it's two different workflows, two different environments, even though they do the same thing at the end of the day. But I think they both have their strengths and weaknesses. And one of the weaknesses of FL Studio is recording. I don't want to say mixing, because you can still mix in FL Studio very well. But I really enjoy the workflow that I have here in Studio One, and the plugins look really cool. So let's go ahead and do something here. So let's add a track. So to add a track, we either use the T shortcut, or we can right click in this area here and let's add a track, and let's have this audio. Okay. Now let's find some loops, just some drum loops. Let's play this. No, I want actual drum loops. Okay, let's see if we have loops here. Drums, let's go to drums, loops. Yeah, here. I would like to have a complete drum loop, not maybe, I don't think I can. Oh, I like this one. This one sounds nice, even though it doesn't have kicks, but we could add kicks ourselves. So let's play this. I actually like this. Sounds really cool. Let's, by the way, do a loop. Let's bring the volume, because this is clipping. Let's put there. Okay, so we have now the loop here. And this is sounding cool. So let's expand the mixer so that we can just focus on the mixer. So as you can see, this is very handy. You can just drag and drop stuff. You can arrange stuff here. You can also expand or make this a different window, as you can see here, detached. So we could make this just a floating window. And I usually don't work this way. I have it built in or undetached. But yeah, I mean, you can also do this in FL Studio. You can also detach windows. So let's go ahead and see. So let's say that I want to add some effects here. If I go to the effects section here with the browser, so you can open up this here and you can hide the mixer also. So let's say that I want to add some EQ. I can just drag and drop an EQ here, and then I can start doing my EQ as I want. Let's add a low pass filter. Okay, I like that. And so now let's say that I want to add some sand effects. I could just, for instance, let's say that I want to add some reverb to this track. One thing that I can do is I can drag and drop a reverb. So let's go find a reverb here. And let's use Comvology XT. I can drag and drop here in the sand. And you see that now I have an insert here. And basically I can, this is basically a copy of the, is sending a copy of the EQ of the processed channel into this plugin here. And then we have these parallel. So if I take this off, you see that it's, doesn't have reverb. If I add reverb, let's make this a little bit more intense. So now let's say that I have this, I like this. Let's bring now another loop just for simplicity or just to showcase what I mean. And let's bring some pianos. I like this one. Let's take the mixer. Let's bring this one here and let's duplicate this. As you can see, it's very intuitive to work with this tool. It's very simple. You just drag and drop stuff. Okay. So now we have a cool loop, a very jazzy loop. So now let's say that I also want to add the same reverb to the piano. So what I could do is just drag this and drop, and now we have the same effect here. But you start to imagine that if I want to start bringing, if I want to, let me unselect that or select just the piano so that we have the selection, the full selection. So let's say that I want to start to add more elements, more instruments. And then I get to the point where I have like, I don't know, maybe 10 or 20 tracks. And if I want to apply the same effect to all of them, this starts to be a little bit hard because now I have to always copy and paste the same plugin. And then if I want to change the configurations of the plugin, or if I want to change the entire level that I send to this plugin, now I have to manually go into every single one, and let's say it's 17.9, then I have to go here 17.9, and I can't even find the correct point. So as you can see, it starts to be a little bit cumbersome, and it's not that easy to start to work this way. Sometimes if you just want an effect in a single track, that's fine, and you can just drag and drop here to the sends, but there's a better way to do this. And as you can see here, we already have a track here, so let's remove this one. And actually, I think this did it for us. So what this did was it recognizes that I wanted, that I had two instances of the same plugin in the sense. So what it did was it created just a new track, a new effects channel, and just added, as you can see here, we have effects, and just added the effects there and just used sense. So Studio One is also very, very, let's call this aux reverb. Studio One is very intelligent in this type of workflows. So that's why this saves a lot of time, because then I would have to create a new effect and then just change here the parameters and so on, and changing the effects and removing and then adding a new one. And then it's kind of a mess sometimes if you want to go back. But Studio One just makes it very, very easy and intuitive to work with. And if, as you see, we had two instances of the same plugin in the sense, so it recognizes this would make much more sense with as an effect channel. But let's now do it manually. So what we can do here is we can go to this area of the canvas of the mix, and we can right click here, and we have a bunch of options. We have the effects, we have the bus, and I'm going to start with the effects, and then we can talk about the bus. I'm not talking about I'm not going to talk about VCA and auxiliary channel. I'm just going to talk about these ones because these are the ones that I use the most. So let's now create a effects channel, and in this one I will call it delay, like so. And let's bring a delay here. And the good thing about this one is that I can start with a delay, and I can also put some EQ now, and I can shape the delay as I want. And let's do, for instance, a high cut or a low cut, a high pass filter. And we can also add a very soft high cut, just for the sake of it, just because we can. So now let's play. And what we can do now is go here to the sends, and let's say that I want to send this one here. I can just drag it and drop, and now we have the delay in the drums. So it's very simple. You could also come here to the plus and add either the delay or this one. Let's use this one. I don't know what's the difference, to be honest. Okay, created a new one. That's not what I meant. That's not what I wanted. So let's see if just if I bring. Oh, maybe because I did the insert. So let me see if I. No, I think there's no way for me to just drag and drop, because what I did was just drag, as you can see, add effects channel. So this creates a new effect, and I can also add the same plugins there. I could add them here. As you can see, we could replicate by just dragging and dropping. So let me remove all of them. But that's not exactly what I want. So what I can do is go here. I added the delay. I can drag and drop the delay again. And we have now the delay on both tracks. And one good thing about this is that let's say that I want overall to change the delay volume. What I can do, instead of going here to the sends, I can just control everything through this delay knob. This sounds really cool, actually. And this delay also makes it bounce a little bit. I really like it. Let's take the effects. As you can see, a little bit dry. And in this case, just makes it a little bit more moody, a little bit more evolving, and the delay just gives it a little bit of extra rhythm that I really like. But that's not the point here. I get carried away with the vibes of the beats, but the idea here is to show you the effects and buzz channel. So I talk about the effects channels. Now let's create a buzz channel. So to create a buzz, we can again go to the empty area here. We can just do add buzz channel like this. And let's call this mix. So now we could just go, how do we send this data to the bus channel? It's a little bit different than the effects channel, because in the effects channel, I was using this as a send. So I would take the copy of this channel and send it through the effects channels. But now I have this mix here, and the mix is the bus channel is a little bit different than the effects channel, because the bus channel is used to route other tracks. So let's say that I want to route track one, or the drums. Let's call this the drums, and let's call this piano, just to so that you know which track I'm talking about. So let's say that I want to route the drums to the mix here. What I could do is, instead of going to the sends or anything, I can just go here. If I click on the main, now you see all the options that I have. I can also route the output of the channel directly into the effects, but that kind of defeats the purpose of the effects channel. For that, I think it's the buzz the best option. So let's send this to the mix channel. And you can see now this is a little bit changed. So now if I play, we still have the drums, we still have everything. But if I mute this mix channel, now we just have the piano, and we also have the auxiliary effects here, the reverb and delay. Why? Because they are going to the main, which is this track here. As you can see, this is the main. If I call this, let's say master, it would change there to master. So as you can see that the piano is going directly to the master, and these tracks here also go to the master. What I could do, for instance, is go here and send also the piano to, instead of sending to the master, I could send it through the mix. So let's do that. And now we just only hear these tracks here. And what I like to do, basically, in this case, as you can see here, we are sending the same amount of delay from the drums and the piano. We are sending the same amount to this track here, to the delay. So what I like to simply do is just use a send in the mix like that, and then I can remove this one and then remove this one. So it makes it more easy for me to just go ahead and change the delay amount either here or in the delay knob. This is the case where you only want to have your, you only have an effect that you want to apply to everything. And you can just, instead of going and copy every single track or every single send to every single track, you just send everything to a bus channel, and then you route the sends to the effects channel that you want. In this case, if I play, you now only hear the reverb. Why? Because this is sending this copy into the bus, into the mix channel, into this bus channel called mix. And then I'm sending a copy to the delay here. So because we have no sound in the mix channel, there's no sound also going to the delay. But now if I unmute this, we can still hear that we have the piano, the drums, and also the delay here. So how would we do this for the piano here, for the auxiliary reverb? Sorry, we would do the same thing. So let's bring a copy of this one. And let's remove these ones. And now let's unmute the auxiliary reverb. So now, as you can see, we have pretty much the same thing, the same composition that we had with the same effects. But now we have a single place where we can control the volume of the sends, and we can also control the volume of the sends here with the knobs themselves. But now we have a little bit more control over like the entire effect that applies to the entire mix. Another way to do bus tracks or bus channels is you select the tracks that we want and we right click on them and we use this option here, add bus for selected channel. So this is also a very fast way for us to add bus channels, and this is how we can do it. So I think that's it for Studio One and how to use effects and bus channels. And I hope you understood the difference between the two. It's not that complicated, but if you are starting out, this can be a little bit confusing and when to use one over the other one. And I hopefully help you with that question.